There's something very disturbing when you think about the fact that Japan has been depending on the Pacific Ocean for centuries, and they are still dumping millions of gallons of radioactive material straight into the ocean. But there's more to the story, because this has been going on now for 3 years. So I'd like to take a look at some of the other atrocities that Japan has performed in the past regarding their sea dumping of chemical weapons. This is from Global Green USA. It's a U.S. affiliate of Green Cross International, authored by Ryo Sato. Various kinds of toxic gases, signal barrels, pipes, and balloon bombs were produced in Japan until the end of World War II. During that time, chemical weapons were categorized into 6 colors, including toxic chemicals such as mustard, Lewisite, phosgene, and hydrogen cyanide. Table 1 shows the list of poison gases made by the former Japanese government. Vomiting agent in Japan was mixed with DA and DC, and in this paper, all the chemical agents listed below will be considered as chemical weapons, including chloroacetophenone, which was often used by the Japanese army in China during World War II. So we've got blister agents, choking agents, hydrogen cyanide, blood agents, vomiting, sneezing, riot control, toxic smoke producing. Here's a Lewisite factory on the island of Ohkuno, Hiroshima Prefecture. Chemical weapons were either dumped by the Japanese Army during and after World War II, or by the Allied forces, mainly under the command of the United States, between 1945 and 1948. Complete records on chemical weapons have not been found. However, the current Japanese government acknowledges that more than 15 chemical weapon factories and laboratories operated inside Japan until 1945. At the end of the Second World War, more than 30 chemical weapons stockpiles are reported to have existed in Japan. Most of the chemical weapons were dumped by either the Japanese or the Allied forces. In other words, massive amounts of chemical weapons were dumped in a relatively short period around the end of World War II. The 5 major types of chemical weapons produced by the Japanese Army before the Second World War were mustard, Lewisite, hydrogen cyanide, DA, and DC. This is a table showing the major sea dumped Japanese chemical weapons with the date, location, and type of disposal by country. So here you can see it's not, and it wasn't, just Japan. The US, Australia, and here's the locations. Reported chemical weapons dump sites. For such a small island as Japan, it seems like an awful lot of dump sites. So here's a little bit more detail. Lakes, oceans, rivers. What the chemicals were, I find this to be extremely disturbing, but I do know and realize that this is going on in every country. The island of Ohkuno is located in the southeast area of Hiroshima. It has a coastline of 4.3 kilometers and covers an area of 71 hectares. Although Ohkuno has been developed as a national vacation village and has become a public health resort today, yeah, paved paradise and put up a vacation village. The island produced poison gases for the Japanese army from 1929 to 1945. Chemical weapon factories were built in the west and southwest area of the island, as indicated in the two red circles, the figure to the right. The Japanese army started manufacturing equipment from France and evacuated all the residents from Ohkuno off the coast of Hiroshima. The army started producing chemical weapons on the island and erased the island of Ohkuno from the map. Phosgene production started. Tear gas production started. Okay. The army ordered the destruction of evidence of chemical weapons, including all the documents. The Allied forces under the command of the United States dumped about 3,000 tons of chemical agents and weapons into the Pacific Ocean, and the U.S. Army burned and disassembled the factories of chemical weapons in Ohkuno. After the government erased the island of Ohkuno from the map, people were not allowed to take photos or even draw pictures. Furthermore, people in the train had to shut the blinds while the train passed next to Ohkuno Island. Production per month in metric tons that was performed on the island of Ohkuno. Some photographs of, I'm sure, a beautiful island that was raped, pillaged, and destroyed. According to the result of research conducted by the Japanese Ministry of the Environment, reported in 2004, that since 1945 there had been 822 incidents, including the discoveries of chemical weapons incidents of human health consequences and the government's handling of the chemical weapons. So here is a table, sadly, that goes through and lists when it was found, what kind of chemical weapon it was, and how many injuries and deaths it caused. Toxic symptoms, children being injured, and people dying. That's just from finding. It's just from finding them, coming across it. Sad. Chemical weapons washing ashore. Four people died from 19 kilograms of toxic gas. Because the way they dumped it and buried it and burned it really probably worked, it didn't work, because it doesn't matter how much of it did work in their dumping. Anytime you have one person that dies from this, equates to me into saying that it didn't work. The Japanese Army announced the outline of chemical war preparation against the United States. This document outlined retaliation against the U.S. by using chemical weapons in case the U.S. Army used chemical weapons first. The locations of stockpiles were decided by the Japanese government to be in Shanghai, Manila, Singapore, Truk Lagoon, and Sapporo and Ugina. The precise amount of chemical weapons that came from each of these stockpile locations is unknown. This raises the possibility that chemical weapons might have been dumped also at sea, not only in China, but also in other Asian and Pacific countries. Furthermore, statistical data also shows the possible existence of chemical weapons in other Asian countries. According to Yoshiaki Yoshimi, a professor at Chuo University, 6,616 tons of chemical weapons were produced in Ohkuno Island alone. However, only 3,647 tons have been found since the end of the Second World War. This implies that nearly 3,000 tons were somehow disposed of in other Asian Pacific countries in order to fight the Allied forces. Because of the undiscovered chemical weapons, another problem is the issue of sunken ships. There is a possibility that chemical weapons are inside the sunken ships, and during the Second World War, 7,240 Japanese commercial ships alone were sunk, most of them in the Pacific Ocean. World War II sunken vessels combining AMIO and SPREP databases. Just unfathomable, unconscionable destruction, intentional destruction. There's no way that they wouldn't have known that this would cause problems in the future. Unbelievable. Oh, there's, of course, fishermen that have found chemical dump sites. They never reported it because they were afraid that they wouldn't be able to sell their fish. These are the incidents that were reported. The above statement implies that the Japanese government still does not have a clear method to remedy the problem of sea-dumped chemical weapons inside their country. To minimize the threats of chemical weapons discovery from water to the human health, the government should make specific guidelines related to sea-dumped chemical weapons. Oh, they now have a great cover-up. You can just blame everything on Fukushima Daiichi. As always, God bless. I will leave links for everything below.